Hey, TC, DHA's Box of Rock with my good friends, the Dead Daisies, John Corabi, Marco Mendoza, two living legends of rock and roll, too, right? Love you guys.
And an adult film, you know, adult porn industry as well.
Well, yeah, that's the side project. That's
the living.
We are today.
Yeah, we are.
So listen, I talked about you guys being living legends. I want to know about some of the music that has moved you over the years. We do the Songs That Changed My Life segment here in the Box of Rock, and I would love to know some of the tunes where you guys had that musical epiphany. You were kids, maybe you were adults. You were like, wow, this is a moving song for me. This is what I want to do with my life. This is who I think I am. John, we'll start with you.
Well, I'm actually going to go a little farther than I probably should. So I'm going to give you four songs that I think totally changed my direction. First off, the first song that I ever heard by the Beatles was Ticket to Ride. And I heard that and I freaked. I'm like, what am I listening to? This is insane. And then I learned all the words and I'd sing along with it, air guitar and all that. I just knew at that point I wanted to be like a musician. Then later I heard Abbey Road, and there was something in, we were talking about it yesterday. There was something in Paul McCartney's voice on two songs on Abbey Road, Oh Darlin' and Golden Slumbers, where he kind of sings. He's got this really cool, soft-ish kind of voice, very clear. And then he kicks his voice into overdrive in the bridge, you know, whatever in the chorus. He does it again and Maybe I'm Amazed, but that was later. And then I would have to say the one artist that really kind of made me realize that kind of image was as important was, the whole album in general was Rise and Fall, Ziggy Stardust and the Spiders from Mars. Every song in that, like I was just crazy and I was looking at Bowie's image and it just blew me away. I'm like, okay, there's a visual part to this that people get as well. And then the last one, I would have to say Bohemian Rhapsody, because I'm like, wow, this guy just took music to a whole other level. And I just want to be, when we get into the studio, there's something like, I want to be as creative as Queen was, or even the Beatles to that degree. You know what I mean?
And that stays with you.
Yes.
I mean, those moments have stayed with you, obviously, where you feel like you're discovering what you're discovering for the first time.
Yeah, like and it still blows me away. There's a little bit of a Netflix, it's called the Classic Album Series.
Oh, I love that.
And they break down
very
like
cool
every song on the Night at the Opera album by Queen. And it's just like the mental, I don't get it. Like the fact that Freddie Mercury could go on a 4 or 5 day vacation and not have that song, went on a vacation and came back with the song written and completely mapped out in his head. Just, it tortures me to this day.
Amazing.
All right. So Marco, give us some of your inspiration.
And I'm thinking about an answer. I'm thinking two songs. It's so hard to pick two songs. And for me, the same as John, Abbey Road was the first album I ever got. And my dad got it for us for Christmas. Up until that point, you know, you're hearing a lot of classical stuff. I grew up with my grandma, who was a piano teacher at home. So there was a lot of classical stuff going around. But when that album arrived, it was just, I knew something was up. And then another epiphany that I had was the first Jaco Pastorius solo album, bass player, being a bass player. That album to this day is mind-blowing as a bass player, as a soloist, because he just opened the door to a new genre.
And that's so incredible. Did you hear that as a child?
No, I was, Jaco came in later. I mean, as a bass player, that just opened another.
And there's actually a Netflix documentary on
about
him as
Jaco.
Well. It's insane.
Yeah, it's sad. It's a sad story. He was so talented and he had some issues, but the bass world changed.
Yeah.
He completely changed the whole approach of bass playing. And to this day, I don't know a lot of bass players that weren't influenced or inspired by him.
Sure. He was like the Eddie Van Halen
on bass. It was mind-blowing. So, when I heard, when I dropped the needle on Abbey Road, I knew something was up. Air guitar with a broom with my brother for hours and hours and hours, the whole album.
Yeah, and it's crazy because as much as I'll look at like Night at the Opera as being like a musical kind of masterpiece, so was Abbey Road, like right. that whole second side, the way they amazing. Ran one song into the next, into the next, into the next.
Yeah, amazing.
That's just insane. It's so creative. It's unbelievable.
And then I was, the trippy thing for me is I was in Mexico, too. I didn't move to the States until I was 14, 15. So that was 2 or 3 years before that. And then I have to say this, first concert ever, Alice Cooper.
Wow.
In San Diego Sports Arena, back in 1935, right? Well, first concert ever.
Wasn't that his record showcase, right? It wasn't actually his, yeah.
It was, yeah, right. Yeah. Awesome. But it was going to San Diego Sports Arena, and everybody was smoking weed. So it must have been the contact thing. But because it was, I'll never forget that thing. It was like, wow.
That was a real moment. That was your real epiphany.
Totally. That was like, boom. I want to do that. I want to be there.
That's and great. Guys.
I had to tell Alice that.
You did? Yeah. And he said.
Like, he was flattered.
Yeah, you know, of course.
He's such a.
Of course. Great guy. Super humble guy. Yeah. Guys, it's always amazing to hear what's inspired artists that inspire us so much. Thank you guys so much.
When do we do the oil, Terrie? It's the only reason why I'm here. I am just, they said I was going to WDHA, and I'm like, cool, I can get Terrie to lather me down in oil again and shave my back.
That's what we do. We do that every time he's here.
Let's get on this.
Hair free.